Hey everyone, Rob J here, and welcome back to the Nova. Today we're looking at two bosses from Alice in Wonderland and the Adventures of Batman and Robin. Check it out. During the Cheshire cat fight, the only vulnerable area is his nose, and keep in mind, this is your safe zone from his claws. The stage lights fall in certain patterns, and you have to have quick reflexes to dodge them, or if you're lucky, be in the right spot. While these are hard to dodge, once they have hit the ground, the lights can no longer damage you. For the first two phases of his eye blast, you can stand in the middle of his face. From there on, be cautious. Once the eye blast starts to curve, go to the opposite direction and jump kick. After you defeat him, the fight isn't exactly over. Make sure you dodge the falling face. The beginning of the fight starts off quite easy with just Humpty Dumpty projectiles and exploding rabbits. But believe me, there's more to come. Keep in mind, the best power-up to get in this fight is the orange batarang, as the projectile spreads, which is handy as you will not have time to stand and line up shots. The obstacles do have a pattern, but you'll definitely get hit. Just remember, don't panic. Brush off the hit and position Batman accordingly. I love the 3D effect in this boss fight, as it allows you to see the obstacles as they move in from the background. My final piece of advice for this boss fight is to gauge when to use Batman's jump and jump kick. His jump kick should be used when the path speeds up, and his normal jump should be used when it slows down. Don't forget to destroy his hat for an extra life. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for a gory easy boss fight from Splatterhouse 3. And remember, if you liked what you saw, please like and subscribe. And if there's a boss fight you would like to see, comment below. I'm Rob J, thank you for entering the Nova, and I'll see you next time. Take care.